Yeah, this one, a gate having a shape of
No,
quadrangle,
no,
the circle, that one.
no, no.
Oh, this
A
one.
vertical square area.
Vertical square area. Where that question? Vertical square area. Let me see what have I.
In assignment, it is question
Okay,
number 4.
let me see.
Sir, this one, a vertical square area, 1 meter into 1 meter.
I didn't know this. Huh, so 1 meter into 1 meter. But I have also shared to you now, so I should also have that same question with you actually. Is this tutorial, Baksit?
To move down.
This one, okay. Yeah, question 4 is two places now. So you have vertical square area 1 meter by 1 meter, submerged in water with the upper edge 0.5 meter below the horizontal surface. Locate a horizontal line on the surface such that force on upper portion is equal to the force on the lower portion. So how have you means started it? I think I can just change the orientation so you're on board. Anyone tried this one?
Yes.
Okay. So, have you drawn your figure? I hope you can see this board, right? So let me use
Yes,
it.
sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So I hope you can hear something. Can you hear?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes,
Yes,
sir.
sir.
Right
Sir.
there? Yes, sir.
Okay. So what you have there, you have a surface here. I think visible. Now you are putting a vertical square. So a square is something like that. So you have water also here. Okay. This side also you have water, not actually this side, because it will not give anything. So this is something like that. So this is your free surface which is open to atmosphere. Now this means upper edge is your point 5 meter below the free surface, right? So this is 1 meter by 1 meter. So the dimension here is also 1 meter. This is also 1 meter. This is also 1 meter, and this one is also 1 meter. So what are you somehow you want to find? Let's say you have this portion is the something like that. So let's say this much portion you have submerged in upper portion. Let's say you have taken that is H. So the lower one would remain to you is actually 1 minus of
H. H,
because the total was 1 meter. So from here, let's say upper portion height is H, lower portion height would remain 1 minus H. So what they want to calculate, that force exerted on this first portion here, let's say F on top portion here, and then you are calculating
how
much.
Sir, उल्टा दिख रहा
है. हाँ.
Like 0.5 आपने मीटर लिखा वो उल्टा दिख रहा है.
Yeah, 0.5 is from the free surface on top.
वो तो सर ठीक है उल्टी दिख रही है डायग्राम.
What happened? What are you saying?
सीधी है सर.
सही है सर. It's all right, sir.
Sir, she is saying कि उसको डायग्राम उल्टा दिख रहा है.
If you are saying this, speak the louder so that I can hear, because I don't have the speaker on this the laptop. I can hear from that only.
Sir, उसको डायग्राम उल्टा दिख रहा था पल्लवी को.
क्या कह रहे हो?
सर, उसको पल्लवी को डायग्राम उल्टा दिख रहा था.
डायग्राम बाकी को जो है दिख रहा है ना?
हाँ जी सर, सब बाकियों को सब दिख रहा है.
बाकी को दिख रहा है तो अब मैं क्या कर सकता हूँ? तो व्हाट यू हैव हियर, यू हैव वाटर टिल दिस टॉप, योर प्लेट यू हैव द सबमर्ज 0.5 मीटर ब्लो फ्रॉम द टॉप एक्चुअली, एंड देन दे वांट टू कैलकुलेट द फोर्स ऑन अपर सेक्शन ऑफ द प्लेट इज दिस वन should be equal to this much. So you want to calculate what should be that, because as you will go to the lower and the lower side, your force would be more. Therefore, this particular length should be slightly less as compared to the top section to balance the forces actually. So you are calculating what should be the force on lower section also, force on bottom section, and equate the forces on both the sides. So if I for time being remove the water from here, so you are balancing the forces. So suppose you are calculating this is your y direction here, and let's say you are calculating a differential y. Let's say this much is your differential y dy. So can you calculate the what should be the corresponding pressure to the point y? What should be the pressure here, Py? Can anyone tell the expression?
Pdy, sir.
What should be the Py?
Rho g 0.5 plus y.
Will anyone the respond something?
Sir, rho g 0.5 plus dy.
Yes, so let's say for time being you are considering this as H. So your Py would be your rho G H plus Y. That is the simple as we are following in the previous all calculations. Now you know the Py, you can calculate the force. So how much is your DFH? DF on this your Py into your dA, right? So you know the expression for So you know the expression for P by is rho G H plus Y P by, your dA is nothing but your dy into y, because you have your dy and your width. So width is 1 meter actually. So at the place of W, you can put just 1 meter. Okay. And now, yes, if sir. You want to calculate this total force on the top section, so you can integrate it, let's say from 0 to h, because this this much you have considered just h only. So 0 to h, you have your rho g h plus y, your width is just 1, so you just have dy, integrate that. So from here you will get rho g h y plus y square upon 2, and this limit is getting changed from 0 to h. So you can substitute the limit here. So your expression for this, where can I write? I can write this side. So your expression for force on top section would be your rho g, your h into this small h, plus you have h square upon 2. So this is the force on top section. Is that fine till here?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Right, you got the force on top section. Now you calculate the same way force on bottom section. Let me clean it. So again, you can redraw it. So this is what you have. This much is your h. You have taken this much, you have considered h there. Now, so you did top part. So let's do the bottom part. So now you can, for the safer side, you start your coordinate from the here. You can take your coordinate from the here previous one, but I would say for the safer side, just take your coordinate system now from here. So if you will start your coordinate system, so this is your y now. So same thing you do for here also. So this is your dy. Your width is just 1, which is your this. Now you calculate what is the pressure corresponding to this here again. So you will write the expression for Py. Can you tell me what would be that? Your rho g. What should I write here?
H plus Z.
Yeah, you have H. Capital H plus small h plus y, right? Because you came down by this value plus this value. Now this much is y from here, so that is your total h now. Fine?
Yes, sir.
So you can calculate your differential force now. Same way, your Py into dA. So your expression for p by rho g h plus this, this is your p by, your da is again same, w, y into your w. So integrate that. So if you will integrate that, you will get again by integration, you will get rho g, w is just one. So you will get here h y, again this h y, plus you have this y square upon 2. And this is changing from how, from where to where? This is 0, and this much is only 1 minus h, because total were 1 only. So this section is just 1 minus h only. So you have 0 to 1 minus h. Substitute that here. So you will get expression for fv is your rho g. So you can substitute here. So what would be here? You have h here. So h, y is just 1 minus h, plus you have h, 1 minus h, h square upon 2. So this is your bottom force. Now they want that these force should be equal of top section force. You got the top section force, F on top section, you have F on bottom section. Balance the two actually. So you will get your H actually. You will get H. So you have to solve it by nonlinear equation and the solve it. Ho jayega?
Yes.
But if you solve now, you have to balance four. Your yes, previous sir. Section F on top came how much? Your rho G, it was H into H plus, ये आपका टॉप सेक्शन में फोर्स था, राइट? यस और नो? दिस वाज़ द फोर्स ऑन टॉप सेक्शन, दिस यू गॉट बॉटम सेक्शन, इक्वेट बोथ द फोर्सेस एंड कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू ऑफ स्मॉल एच, कैपिटल एच यू ऑलरेडी नो 0.5. विल इट बी सॉल्व नाउ?
यस सर.
Yes,
okay.
Sir.
So if you, so that way you can complete it. Any other doubt?
Sir, worksheet 3, question number 3.43.
Yeah.
So worksheet 3, question number 4.43, in which we have to calculate the relation change for
which
the
one,
pressure.
Which question you are talking? So in that case, which question? 6
sir,
or 5?
Sir, 3.43.
3.43, that one from worksheet 1.
So worksheet 3.
Okay, let me see where that. This is there. On a certain calm day, a mid inversion causes atmospheric temperature to remain constant at 85 degree Fahrenheit between sea level and 1600 feet altitude. Under these conditions, calculate the elevation change for which a 2% reduction in air pressure occurs. So determine the change of elevation necessary to effect a 10% reduction in density and plot this and this as a function of Z. So were you present in the class the time we have talked about this effect of elevation on pressure and density?
Sir, basically, I am not able to know about how to approach the question, ma'am. So, sir.
हाँ वही तो बात कर रहा हूँ मैं भी. सो फॉर दैट वर यू प्रेजेंट दैट डे?
ऑन व्हिच डे सर?
क्या हुआ?
सर कौन से दिन?
जिस दिन ये पढ़ाया गया था. क्योंकि दिन तो मुझे भी नहीं पता. आई कैन ओनली से किस दिन पढ़ाया गया था. एनी वे आई माइट हैव द सॉल्यूशन हियर. एक्चुअली आई कैन डिस्कस. Let me see if I have the answer in this file, because yeah, this is what I taught to you one day actually, if you can recall. Can you see this one?
Yes, sir.
हाँ, सो दिस इज व्हाट आई टॉट यू ए लॉन्ग टाइम बैक. द प्रेशर वेरिएशन एलिवेशन एक्चुअली. सो इन दिस केस द लीनियर टेम्परेचर वेरिएशन बीइंग कंसीडर्ड दैट टी इक्वल टू टी जीरो इंटू माइनस एम जेड. सो एज यू विल गो अप योर टेम्परेचर डिक्रीजेस. सो फाइनली यू गॉट योर रेफरेंस. दिस चेंज इन डेंसिटी, दैट्स व्हाट यू वांट देयर ना, चेंज इन डेंसिटी. So this will come this that p upon p naught t zero upon t minus 1 into 100. So let's see, I might have solved that question also. This is that poker thing. So this is what you have. You can see this solution there. So temperature was 80 degree Fahrenheit. Z was 16,000 feet. So Fahrenheit you can convert to Celsius actually. So that's 3 upon 5 F minus 32 upon 9. And then you convert it to this temperature into Kelvin. So you can directly convert maybe Fahrenheit to Kelvin or Celsius to Kelvin. Choice is yours. Now this is your expression for dp upon dz equal to minus rho g. This is the pressure variation with respect to z, right? You already know that. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So then you have ideal gas law, pv equal to nRT. So from here the density would be the p upon rT. Correct?
Yes, sir.
So you have dp expression. So at the place of dp you can substitute this here. So your dp is minus rho rt upon g into z. So integrate that. You got here delta z equal to minus rt g ln p2 upon p1. So from here then you have expression for your density rho 1 equal to this, density rho 2. So you get rho 1 upon rho 2 equal to P1 upon P2 for constant temperature. That's what they say, the temperature is constant. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So at the place of this pressure, P1 upon P2, you can just substitute this density here. So delta Z equal to minus RT upon G ln rho 1 upon rho 2, because this is what you got from here for constant temperature. So if you will substitute that here, so you will substitute here. So finally, you can calculate your gas constant for air is 286.9. So you have there. Now you want 2% reduction actually. So the 2% of this rho 2 is 2% change of your rho 1. So matlab, rho 2 is 98%, means the 0.98 of rho 1. So that's what you did here. You have substituted everything here. You have R, you have temperature, you have G, only thing inside bracket you have just changed this row 1, this is 2% change when the decrease there, so you have 0.98 of row 1 here, row 1 or p1, because both rows are getting same. So that way you calculated delta as 178.876 meter. This is 2% reduction in temperature. So then next is 10% the reduction in density. So you just calculate 10%, 10% would become 0.9, and rest of the things same, because constant temperature, you are just finding that rho 1 upon rho 2 is equal to your p1 upon p2, right?
Yes, sir.
Is that fine?
Yes, sir.
Anything else?
Sir, just want to know the answer. Worksheet number 2 ka, question number 3 ka answer.
Kitna aaya? Mujhe thoda yaad hai, shayad uska. You tell me the answer.
Sir, 125.63 kilopascals.
बट वहां तो आपको एच कैलकुलेट करना है, स्मॉल एच, पास्कल तो कैलकुलेट ही नहीं करना.
नो सर, प्रेशर डिफरेंस, डिफरेंशियल मैनोमीटर का क्वेश्चन है ये.
अच्छा, ये मुझे लगा कि जो अभी पीछे सॉल्व किया है उसकी बात कर रहा
है. सर, इस स्मॉल एच 0.6 मीटर.
यस यस, 0.61 एक्चुअली. सर, so that way you are making sense also, because upper section should be longer, because their pressure intensity is low compared to the bottom section, because bottom section your pressure is high, so small area can give you that much force actually. Acha, let's see what is she talking about, which question that answer actually the solution I have not scanned actually, so I may not have here. So only thing I can tell you now actually this procedure only, that how to solve it, because I hope I don't have that solution can scan to here. You were talking which question here? Which question was there?
3.
Question number 3, a differential manometer of 5, this, this I can recall, I think, okay. And specific gravity 0.9, 0.8, 0.8 meter flow, if mercury level left limb is this, and difference level of mercury to the point, find the pressure difference. Or kisi ne kiya nahi? So I can show you,
yes,
the figure.
Sir.
और किसी ने किया है?
तो कौन सा क्वेश्चन?
यस,
क्वेश्चन नंबर 3,
क्वेश्चन नंबर 3,
डिफरेंशियल मैनोमीटर कनेक्टेड टू ए पाइप समथिंग.
यस सर, किया
है. देखो, दो लोगों ने किया है, तो यदि आंसर मैच करता है तो दैट मे बी फाइन. कितना आ गया आपका?
सर, 125.636 किलोपास्कल.
एंड योर आंसर पल्वी?
125.63.
So that means it makes sense. Still, मैं आपको फिगर बना के दिखा देता हूँ, so that you can get the idea के आपने जो फिगर बनाया है वो ठीक है कि नहीं. बाकी means answer तो match कर रहे, it means might be correct. So let's see here. So a differential manometer connected to a specific gravity. Okay, so this is your figure, and if you will write the equation for that, so this would be your PA. You are coming down here, so let's say, so it's plus here, rho A G, so it is 0.2 plus 0.95. Now you came down here, so you are going this much up. So this is your, let's say, HB. So you are going up here, you have rho B, G. So total is this actually 0.2, 0.95 minus of 0.8 equal to 0. Correct. So this way, have you drawn the figure? So here yes, you have density. Rho A is given 900. Rho B is given 800. G is known to you. So everything is known to you. Substitute here, you will get the answer.
Sir.
Yes.
Hello.
Yeah.
Sir, ye, A se 0.2 meter niche. उसके बाद से मरकरी शुरू हो जा रहा है आई गेस, मतलब उसके बाद उसके नीचे मरकरी.
हां, यस यस यस, एक्चुअली दैट नीड टू बी चेंज हियर, सॉरी, है, लेट मी चेंज इट. सो हियर यू हैव okay, you are right. So I missed the mercury part. Now it's fine. So you have fluid A, so that came till here. Then you have mercury. Now you are going up from here to here. So this is your fluid B. And this one? Aise kiya hai sabhi ne?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that's fine then. Anything else?
Sir, answer different RM. I think.
Different RM means?
Sir, sir, mera 141 point something RM, 141.5.
ये मैंने आपको सारा कुछ वहाँ पे जहाँ लिख दिया, figure लिख दिया, formula लिख दिया. सब कुछ लिख दिया, ये आपका काम है, आप कैसे कैलकुलेट करते हैं, ठीक है? आई रोट यू एवरीथिंग
सर. क्वेश्चन सेवेंथ का आंसर.
क्वेश्चन सेवन, एक मिनट. हेलो
यस सर
यस सर
विच वन वाज द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन
सेवेंथ
सेवन ऑफ ट्यूटोरियल
टू सेम ट्यूटोरियल
ओके हाँ सेवन इज दिस दैट फिगर फोर शोज द सेक्शन ऑफ टैंक विच इज 2 मीटर लॉन्ग एंड फुल ऑफ वाटर अंडर प्रेशर एट 19.62 ओके ए सिलेंडर से करते हैं पूरा ना तो बस ठीक वो मेरा हो गया ठीक है दे दो हाँ सॉरी है सो सिलेंडर ऑफ रेडियस एम इज रेस्टिंग ऑन टैंक एट वन ऑफ इट्स कॉर्नर एज शोन फाइंड द हॉरिजॉन्टल एंड वर्टिकल कंपोनेंट फोर्स एक्टिंग ऑन द कर्व सरफेस ए बी सी ऑफ सिलेंडर नेगलेक्ट द वेट ऑफ सिलेंडर ओके सो फिगर फोर लेट्स सी व्हाट इज फिगर फोर वी हैव सो दिस इज एक्चुअली फिगर फोर हियर सो यू हैव अ प्रेशर इनसाइड दिस पर्टिकुलर टैंक राइट दैट्स व्हाट दे से करेक्ट सो द प्रेशर इज गिविंग
यस
19.6 किलो न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वायर इज एक्चुअली प्रेशर सो दैट इज वन थिंग एट द सेम टाइम इट इज ऑल्सो फील्ड ऑफ वाटर ऑल्सो राइट यस और नो
यस सर
राइट सो अवर प्रोसीजर इज सेम नो मैटर वॉट इज देयर सो वॉट टू डू फर्स्ट सो यू हैव टू take it x y and z also and what is this happening here so I can tell you so have you done this question number 3 means the figure 3 one first ye kiya hai aap logon ne
यस सर
if you have done this could have also be solved
जस्ट वॉन्ट टू नो द आंसर
आंसर तो मेरे पास भी जहाँ नहीं है वो जहाँ ट्यूटोरियल वाली फाइल आई हैव एट होम सो आई डोंट हैव दैट सॉल्यूशन सो ओनली थिंग राइट नाउ आई कैन टेल दैट द प्रोसीजर थिंग बिकॉज द रेस्ट ऑफ द थिंग आर जस्ट कैलकुलेशन ओनली सो आई विल जस्ट ड्रॉ द फिगर फॉर दिस आल्सो सो दैट यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट यू डिड एंड द रेस्ट ऑफ थिंग आर जस्ट कैलकुलेटर पार्ट ओनली सो आंसर तो बाकी लोगों ने भी किया होगा सो यू मे हैव दैट आल्सो सो व्हाट यू हैव देयर So fine, so you have here center. So you can start maybe from here. Fine. Now what you have here, let's say you have, so this is your total theta actually. So let's say you have just changed from here. This is your starting point, you are just changing here. Let's say you have changed small thing here, this one. So now you can calculate how much is this change here. This change here, so let's say this is your x coordinate maybe. So this is your dx. So let's say you have changed by this angle of, let's say, how much? D theta or theta? Let's say you have changed with theta. This is your R. So how much would be your dx would be? R cos? Cos or sine? This is your dx. R sine theta. Now let's say how much you have bent upside here. यहाँ से यहाँ तक का change कितना होगा? So ये थोड़ा visible नहीं है. I can say here or I can change it this slightly here. So let's say you were here and you have changed this distance. ये आपने by change किया. From here, this is your origin here. So from here you bend y distance up. So for that y distance up, you bend to here on this circumference. You came to this point. You came here. Now for that part, so this is your y. So you can calculate how much is pressure corresponding to this point y. So can you tell me how much would be P by here? Any idea? I cannot hear you. Oh, let me draw it. So you have this. So you have rho g, and from here, this total is that. Is this fine till here? Is this fine till here? Or horizontal force you can actually directly calculate, because you need the horizontal force, you need vertical force also.
Both.
Okay. So horizontal force is very the simple actually. In case of the horizontal force, just find a projection of that you can calculate. Yes or no? Or you can calculate from here, integrate this one only. So if you'll integrate this, you will get your horizontal force. If you will integrate that one, this will integration would be for this entire edge from 0 to h only. So that would be your horizontal force. Will that be fine? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, or you have the another way for the horizontal force, because from here also you will get the same thing as it is. So this would be its projection. So projection would be of this. So this length is this is your width actually, or you can say width equal to L equal to 1 meter. This much you already know from here is 1.5. So this is the rectangle actually. So pressure at the centroid you can calculate from here. So the centroid of this would be pressure at the centroid would be your h by 2 is the centroid. and multiply by rho, multiply by g. This is pressure at the centroid. You already have pressure inside the tank, so just add that also. So this would be the pressure at the centroid. Okay. Then I count here. So this would be the pressure at the centroid. You, because this is the pressure only because of the fluid height. This you already have pressure inside the tank. So if you add that, that would be the pressure at the centroid. So pressure at the centroid multiplied by area. So area of this would be h into this w or l, which is your 1 meter. So 1.5 into 1 meter. So that would be your horizontal force. So that way you can calculate that. Okay.
Sir.
Yeah.
सर आई डन बाय अनदर मेथड एक्चुअली जो आपने कर्व सरफेस लिया है इन जो उसके नीचे पानी है उसको मल्टीपल बॉडी कंसीडर कर लिया
मल्टीपल बॉडी
मतलब नॉट अ सिंगल टू पार्ट्स में लाइक फ्रॉम द सरफेस मतलब सरफेस से लेके इसको ग्राउंड तक दो पार्ट्स में डिवाइड कर लिया मल्टीपल बॉडी
ओके
एंड जो फिर फर्स्ट पार्ट था
दो पार्ट में कैसे कन्वर्ट किया I just want to know how it has converted into two part. How?
Actually, sir, जो उसका upper part है, उसके तो पानी ऊपर है, लेकिन जो इसका curve का निचला part है, वो उसके पानी को नीचे आ रहा है। मतलब हम ज़्यादातर क्या करते हैं कि जो curve surface होता है, उसके ऊपर जो पानी होता है, vertical component वैसे calculate किया जाता है।
मैं तो vertical की बात ही नहीं कर रहा for time. This is just a horizontal force only.
ओके आप मतलब ठीक है आपका मेथड भी बट मैंने जो किया जैसे किया मैं वो बता
नो आई मीन टू से यू कैन डू बाय एनी मेथड दिस इज द सिंपलेस्ट वन इफ यू आर कंफर्टेबल विद योर मेथड आई डोंट हैव एनी प्रॉब्लम दैट इज आल्सो द मेथड एक्चुअली जो आप कह रहे हैं वो भी है
एक्चुअली वो सही है
कंफर्टेबल विद दैट
मैंने रेप्लिका लेके कंसीडर किया जो निचला पार्ट है उसको
योर आंसर शुड कम सेम
या इसलिए आंसर मुझे कंफर्म करना था
नो सो आई रोट यू द होल थिंग यू हैव प्रेशर एट द सेंट्रोइड यू हैव ऑल दिस वैल्यू सब्स्टिट्यूट हियर मल्टीप्लाई बाय एरिया इज 1.5 दैट इज योर फोर्स ओनली दैट्स ऑल द सिंपल ओनली
हॉरिजॉन्टल फोर्स तो सर इजी है वो तो सिंपल वैसे ही कैलकुलेट होगा मेन पार्ट इज वर्टिकल
हां हां तो वो भी हो जाएगा डोंट वरी
Horizontal
so,
to simply.
In case of vertical here, the vertical force we have always talked about the previously, that it is just a actually the weight of the fluid displaced, simple only. It is
yes.
just the weight of the fluid displaced, nothing else. So what you have here, so if in this case, what you have. This much of the fluid volume, which is what displaced. So somehow you calculate this volume. Somehow you calculate this volume, multiply by density, multiply by g would be your vertical force only. So somehow you have to calculate this. Okay. So.
Yes.
Are you able to calculate the volume of this section of this particular cylinder? Can you calculate or not? ये for timing fluid को भूल जाइए. Can we calculate the volume of this much segment of the cylinder or not?
Yes.
How would you calculate? Tell me, how would you calculate? What is the full volume of this cylinder? Full volume is pi r square.
Pi r square h. Yeah.
Yes or no? That's all only. Now you somehow you calculate how much is this theta. ये आप theta निकाल लो somehow. ये how much is this theta? So full volume is that pi. r square l. So somehow you calculate how much is this theta portion. So because this volume is covered if the when theta is by 360 degree only. Now theta is just this much. So somehow if you can multiply here, what should be your portion here? So just put here this theta upon 2 pi can give you the answer. Yes or no? This theta upon 2 pi, so if you know this theta in degree, just calculate from here, so you will get this particular volume. Correct or not?
Okay, sir.
Because you got the volume this way. This is the full volume of this entire circle. The when theta was 2 pi. So if you want to calculate full, so your theta will become 2 pi upon 2 pi. Both will get cancelled. So you will get full volume. Now you need just volume of this part. So just calculate theta. So you can calculate theta. So this total length is given to you 1.5. So this is your 1. This much is your 0.5 actually. Let me clean it actually. So this theta you already have 90 from here. Only thing, this you can calculate from here. So how would you calculate that? So you can have here sine theta would be equal to that 0.5 over 1, right? So you can calculate this theta here. So after that you have full theta here. So you can calculate this 90 plus that theta. आ जाएगा? आ जाएगा कि नहीं? Because that way you can calculate how much is this full theta, right? So you got theta, so you can calculate this volume of this cylinder. Because यदि आपके पास cylinder नहीं होता, so your volume would be filled this till this particular point, right? So that way you can calculate the volume of the fluid that had displaced, and that would be your up thrust force or your vertical force only. Fine. And you have to also add in that also your pressure also, because once you are calculating that pressure, so your pressure multiply by area. So area in that particular case, only this much area will try to push it upward only, not full area. Yes or no? Only this much area. This 1/4 will try to push it upward, not this area. This will not push it upward. Okay, so you have one term. One is this fluid force multiplied by volume into density. So that would be one weight here by fluid weight. Another one is by the pressure, because the tank is under pressure also. So in case of that, only this area need to be considered. That is your 1/4 of the cylinder actually. Okay. This is one way. The another way is that there is one more way also, just to calculate the vertical force. So I will tell you that part also. So in that case, what you have, so you have this, so from here, let's say this is your y coordinate, so you bent y distance up. So from here you can calculate what should be your pressure at point Y P Y. So for this pressure here, so P Y. So if you have just change it, just wait. So just changing by Y, you just change how much you have changed. So let's say you have just changed a differential Y here. So let's say you have here. This is your X. How you can say dx. So you can calculate pressure at point Y, no doubt. वहां तक तो ठीक ही रहता है हमेशा rho g, and this total is your h. You have h minus y. This is your pressure. Now you want vertical force. So this is your pressure at point Y. You want a vertical force. The vertical force will act only this area only. So this F vertical would be pressure at point Y, and the area which goes into the y direction only, right? You have pressure rho g. H minus Y. Now you have this vertical area, which is your dx, and your width of the gate, width of the cylinder. So this is your vertical area. This one would be this area only. Okay, this dx into this entire length of the cylinder would be the your Ay, on which this pressure from here will act. This side, which will give you the vertical force. So you have this one. Now you need what is your dx. So can I calculate what is my dx? So if I draw here, so let's say this is my theta. This is your r. So you can calculate what is your x here. So from here, your x would be how much? Your r sine theta. So from here, that your dx would be your r. Cos theta d theta would be your dx. So you got dx. Now you need dy. You just also need y. How would I calculate y? Y is this one. So how much is y here? How much is y in terms of theta? So this total length is r. So your y is your r minus your r cos theta. Because this full length is r, this much from here would be r cos theta. So this total minus this r cos theta would give me the y. So that I will substitute here. So once I will substitute here, I will get expression for your vertical force would be your rho g, h is same. Your y is this, that minus r plus r cos theta. This is your this term. Multiply by dx. Dx is from here. Your r cos theta d theta. Your l is just 1 meter, so you can write 1 here. So this is what your expression for your vertical force. Now only variable is just theta. Integrate that. Now theta. This is your this one. So this is your entire theta. जो आपने पहले थीटा निकाला है. ये आया समझ में क्या किया मैंने? दिस विल सॉल्व यू एंड मींस एवरीथिंग. दिस इज बेसिक फाउंडेशन ऑफ ऑल द थिंग्स व्हाट वी डिड. डू यू हैव द एनी डाउट इन दिस?
No, sir.
Right. This is what the basic foundation, because that's what I always stick to this only. So you have went y distance up from here this much. Calculate corresponding pressure P Y. So P Y would be rho g h minus y. Simple. Now I need vertical force. So vertical force will act only this much area only, which is vertical to that. So this is your dx, and the length of cylinder is L. So dx into L is the area. Now I just need, what is my dx? So dx I can calculate from here. This x would be r sine theta. So from there the dx would be r cos theta d theta. I just need y. So y would be calculated from here. This entire thing is actually r. So r minus this r cos theta of this section would be my y only. So I can substitute everything here. Now this will work everything. You just change, you just integrate it, find the expression for that. So in this, all the time you have to just the substitute your corresponding value of theta, you will get the answer of force. No matter how much is covered, how much is not covered, just keep on changing the theta thing only. Okay?
Yes.
So this way you can calculate forces on all spherical the surfaces actually. Spherical or maybe a circle also, anything which are the there in this particular form, or maybe a curved surface also sometime. Answer I can tell you the next class, because I have answered in different file. Anyone else wants to ask something?
No, sir.
Okay. और किसी को कुछ पूछना है?
सर पेपर्स का क्या सीन है?
कौन सा?
सर पेपर्स कब होंगे?
एज एकेडमिक कैलेंडर इज गिवन ओनली फॉर एंड सेमेस्टर.
सर ऑनलाइन और ऑफलाइन?
I don't know that part actually. Would it be online or not, depending on the situation? But for tentatively, I can tell this is would because what we planned there actually in the beginning, it would be offline exam. Means they may call you to write the exam actually. Even for the practicals also, that's what they wrote here, that your all practicals would be conducted maybe in 1 week time. तो पेपर तो हो ही जाएगा. पेपर का तो इतना टेंशन लेना है, यू आर नॉट प्लानिंग टू गो एनीवेयर. So I would say always include statistics. You just stick to thing. I just taught one thing. So pressure at point Y, always take Y coordinates. Either you are taking it upward or downward. That is choice is yours only. And
horizontal force.
Mic बंद हो गया किसका? मेरा?
सर कोरा किसी का है, कोरा हरि कृष्ण.
क्या देख रहा है एक्चुअली गाइस? पीपल इसको हटा देते हैं. निकला कोरा से सो आई द रिमूव द सो आई जस्ट टेल ओनली इन प्रेशर जस्ट स्टिक टू वन एक्सप्रेशन. प्रेशर इक्वल टू रो जी वाई. If you are calculating horizontal force, just multiply by horizontal area. Means the area whose go means perpendicular on that goes to in horizontal side. So in this case, if you want to calculate horizontal force, horizontal area would be nothing but your dx into L. If you want to calculate this horizontal, only this would change. This would only will become dy into L. Rest of the things are same. If you are just calculating your vertical force, just put here dx, simple. आपको कुछ सोचना ही नहीं है. यू नीड नॉट टू थिंक एनीथिंग. उसके बाद आप जस्ट सब्स्टिट्यूट करिए, वैल्यू इंटीग्रेट करिए. आपको कुछ भी सोचने की जरूरत नहीं है. टू सिस्टम, मल्टीपल सिस्टम, दैट सिस्टम एंड ऑल दिस. यू कैन हैव सो मच सोफिस्टिकेशन एंड कॉम्प्लिकेशन, बट आई विल से जस्ट स्टिक टू दिस माय सिंपल फॉर्मुलेशन ओनली. Okay, so I would just say stick to this only. Is it not the simple one?
Yes, sir.
ये आपको सिंपल ही है. सब को आपको 10th स्टैंडर्ड, 9th स्टैंडर्ड से प्राइजा पे से इक्वल टू रो जी पाई. ओनली हमें सो फोर्स ही निकालना है. सो फॉर दैट ओनली एरिया मल्टीप्लाई कर दिया. एक जगह डी एक्स लिख दिया, एक जगह डी ए वाई. डी ए वाई फॉर वर्टिकल फोर्स एंड डी ए एक्स इज फॉर हॉरिजॉन्टल फोर्स. अब फाइनली आपके फिगर को देख के जस्ट सब्स्टिट्यूट इट. हाउ टू गेट योर डी एक्स एंड वाई एंड डी वाई, दैट्स ऑल ओनली.
सर कितने वेज है ये हॉरिजॉन्टल और वर्टिकल कंपोनेंट्स निकालने के?
देखिए अब वेज ये है, कुछ लोग जैसे आप करते हैं वो आपको हटा दिया. Somehow some people will say they are very good in mathematics, so they can just calculate somehow this volume. जो आपको मैंने वॉल्यूम के लिए बताया था, हॉरिजॉन्टल इज इजी. उसमें आप यू जस्ट फाइंड प्रोजेक्शन. सो इफ यू सी द प्रोजेक्शन ऑन द लेफ्ट साइड और द राइट साइड, प्रोजेक्शन वुड बिकम ए रेक्टेंगल. वट एवर सरफेस इज देयर इज नो मैटर एक्चुअली.
यस,
इट विल ऑलवेज बिकम ए रेक्टेंगल और द स्क्वायर डिपेंडिंग ऑन लेंथ एंड डायमीटर साइड, नो मैटर वट यू हैव. सो दैट इज सिंपल. सो जस्ट इन दैट केस कैलकुलेट द pressure at the centroid would be the half of length divided by 2 and multiply by area. That's all simple. So in case of horizontal, you need not to do much. Vertical case, you have to think, because in this case also, you have to think what is your volume that displays. So somehow we are not comfortable that how to calculate it readily actually. In case of that, by chance, let's say it was 1/4. So you have the easy to calculate, so 1/4 of volume. That's all the simple. Sometimes you have a curved surface, let's say x equal to something y square y cube to the power 3. You can have curved surface where you cannot use the standard formula, let's say 1/4 or 1/3 and all this. So in that case, you have to come back to integral sign only. So I mean to say, you always proceed with this only. No matter what you are having, what type of surface you have, you will always get the answer in the very straightforward manner without any error actually. So I would say stick to this only. They forget about the other things.
So please share the answer of this question by this method on the WhatsApp group.
Yeah, I did only by the this method only. I will tell you the answers. And for you people, that lecture slides I'll upload on this Google Drive today only. Yesterday I forgot actually. So I'll upload for kinematics also, so that aap log at least thoda usko dekh ke kuch rahega ke kya padhane wale hain next time sir, so that you can have some idea. Any other doubt? If there no other doubt, then we can close this thing today. Hello? ये बाकी बच्चे हैं भी क्लास में कि नहीं? उनको देखो जरा बंद बाय बंद कौन कौन है. आस्था सिंगाड़ा, आर यू देयर? कोई है ही नहीं यहाँ पे, यहाँ सब
सर यहीं है.